Welcome to Tramzoya, a county of vast agricultural potential that has been dubbed Kenya's breadbasket. Indeed, Tramzoya has had a long tradition of being the biggest grain-producing county with some of the best farming activities. Located on the western edge of the Rift Valley region, Tramzoya sits between the slopes of Mount Elgon in the west and Cherangani Hills in the east. The two also serve as the county's main water towers, making Tramzoya enjoy ample rainfall and favorable climate throughout the year. County shares borders with the Republic of Uganda to the west, West Pokot County to the northwest, Elgeyo Marakwet to the northeast, Uasin Gishu County to the east, Kakamega County to the south, and Bungoma County to the southwest. It is home to the magnificent caves on the slopes of the Elgon and the only county in the region that boasts of a wildlife attraction. It is a county of true population diversity with peaceful, friendly and hard-working people. Tramzoya County can offer in terms of investment and business.
We're looking at coffee. Coffee does very well here. And I'm saying, if I'm going to have 500,000 acres under coffee in a year or two, I need by now to look for people who are interested, and we agree that I have to produce this quantity and they can come and do a milling plant for coffee. So they start their planning now as I work with the farmers. Yes. Chilies, we're saying we want to produce enough and hopefully add some little value here before we export the chili to India or wherever.
Tramzoya is known basically for agriculture. That is our main economic activity. Because we grow maize, in large scale maize, we grow enough maize for both local and export. We also grow tea, coffee. We are going into macadamia now, bananas, beans, and many other farm produce. Our farmers also grow horticulture crops, and they are doing very well. Our people also rear cattle. We have dairy farmers here. We have beef farmers. We have poultry farmers. We have beekeepers. And we also have trade, of course, in those products and many more. Now, we have a lot of potential in value addition to the agricultural products. Starting from maize, as I said, we have enough maize for local and external consumption. That's why we are known as Kenya's breadbasket. But our farmers are not getting enough income from their maize because all this maize and other farm produce are sold when they are raw. This is where we have huge investment opportunities for people willing to start up factories and investment industries in Tramzoya.
Now we're moving towards renewable energy. We have some rivers on Mount Elgon. Unfortunately, Lake Basin Development Authority had done some studies where 5 megawatts of power, between 5 to 10 megawatts of power could be produced. That is available and ready.
liaison with the Kenya Power and Lighting Company. They are putting up a very big substation within the county. And this will ensure that there will be uninterrupted power supply for use by the locals, by industries, and by investors within the county.
The investment in the opportunities in this country, or environment in this country, is fairly good. It's fairly good. Stable macroeconomic policies, stable currency, power. Now we are reaching at a level where we can assure people that we'll have reasonable power. The cost is also coming down. Accessibility of transport. You've seen investment in SGR railway. You've seen airports like Eldoret, which are within a short time. We're also buying land to expand our local airport here. It can carry slightly bigger planes. The roads to Uganda on Swam border.
And these are some of the advantages that the potential investors will have. We have the road network from Eldoret cutting through Kitale to Swam border, therefore accessing Uganda and South Sudan. We also have the road going to through Kitale again to Lodwa and to South Sudan and Ethiopia. We also have the road network within the county. Well done for any investor to move their goods from one place to another. The road crossing through Kitale to Swam is an international road, and therefore transportation through the county to other countries is also a big business along the way. Talking about hotels being one, talking about now that goods are moving from Uganda, from Mombasa all the way to the landlocked countries of Uganda and others, Kitale and Trans Nzoia County becomes very critical again as a transit county where people will come rest and move their goods to the next level. So we are looking at opportunities for warehousing. We are looking at opportunities for people investing as freight forwarders and so on, those who are involved in transport. So the opportunities are huge.
The Deputy Governor, Dr. Stanley Tarus, is equally confident of the county's investment potential.
We have opportunities like in building of hotels. We have the Mount Elgon Lodge. We have Saiwan Swamp. We want any investor who can do even a three-star hotel at Mount Elgon. Mount Elgon has very good, a large number of elephants, which lives in the caves. So we'd like any investor who can build a state-of-the-art hotel.
When we talk about tourism, we're talking about the circuit crossing all the way from the western region, parts of Uganda, up to Turkana. So therefore, the hotel industry is a big opportunity here. Remember, our neighboring county, which is West Pokot, has also some tourist attraction sites. And don't forget that we're just a stone throw away to Turkana, where we have the first oil coming from there. And this county, with a conducive weather, is the best place for investors to invest, access the oil fields in Turkana, access the tourist sites within the country and outside, access the markets and so on. So hotel industry is very big.
Another sector is the health sector. Currently, as we talk, we don't have a referral hospital to there. Although the county is underway building a referral hospital, we are targeting to make it a teaching and referral. But that is only one. Go to other counties like Eldoret, Nairobi, you'll find there are several private hospitals. We're even opening up to the private sector. Welcome to Trans Nzoia and even build more infrastructure in terms of provision of medical services. The other sector we are targeting is housing. The county even has land that is that has houses that are as old as the municipal was 50 years down the line. Most of those houses have been condemned. So we are thinking through the partnership with the county assembly, we can pass a bill where we get an okay to demolish those old condemned houses. Then we give the land to an investor, NSSF, or National Housing to come and, or any private investor who can build houses and even sell to the local community of Trans Nzoia, to the breadbasket. Come and see, we have the potential. We have a lot of rain in Trans Nzoia. We have good soils in Trans Nzoia. A lot of flower farming is going on in Trans Nzoia. Coffee is doing very well. Tea is doing very well. So we are even telling our farmers, let's diversify our agriculture so that we don't just develop on our monocrop, which is maize. We have an airport in Eldrick, international airport. Flights landing, delivering goods from Middle East, going back empty. We produce a lot of fruits and vegetables for export so that we can even fill those planes coming from Middle East for export. So we are telling the farmer, the world is running. We have to be, our farming also should be dollar driven. Let's not only depending on the Kenya shilling through the maize. Let us look at export crops, which will even empower farmers.
Kitale and Trans-Nzoia as a whole is known as a granary of the entire country, right from the older years. And we will prefer and make sure that we up that and make it even better and let all the other industries come in and support Trans-Nzoia as a county to create more employment, tap the opportunities, the resources that we have. The weather is good, the security is good, and the environment is also very conducive for investment.
Once we have investment here, even the people from these areas who flock to Nairobi will be able to keep them in these areas. And then the country will be able to develop slightly in an even manner rather than the skewed manner that we have seen in the past. This whole circuit could be rejuvenated. And we could have tourists flowing in this area. Once tourists start coming, there are other activities that follow. Where they'll sleep, supplies, curios will be sold, and the economy will have a little bit more money circulating if the tourists were to come to this area.